Nestled in the hills, not far from the urban sprawl of Canberra and Queanbeyan, sits a reservoir that some anglers call a freshwater fishing oasis.
This is a big, big boy.
And this is partly why. Googong Dam is home to some massive Murray cod. Catching a couple launched the career of Rob Paxavanis.
It's a 70, 80 pound fish.
And helped him become the host of his own TV show, Fishing Australia.
It was one of the last remaining freshwater systems that were carp free, and hence it was very clear.
Across the Murray-Darling Basin, carp are a massive problem. In places, they now make up 80 to 90% of the fish biomass, destroying aquatic plants and reducing water quality.
Just there, look at him. Huge.
And in recent years, there have been growing fears they were establishing themselves in Googong. Local angler Paul Orman has seen them a few times.
Were you shocked?
Yeah, I was actually, because I didn't think there was any carp in here, and they kept telling me there was no carp, and I said, oh yeah, but these are carp.
The Parks ACT webpage about fishing states carp are still excluded from the dam, but a government spokesperson confirmed to the ABC that in late 2021, a survey found adult and sub-adult carp, indicating that breeding had taken place.
And it's the word breeding that is really key in that statement, because the odd carp has been seen and even caught here since at least 1990, but it wasn't considered an established or self-sustaining population.
So if they're breeding, they're producing under their own steam, and so a population will take off.
Mark Lintermans has studied freshwater fish in the region for more than four decades and suspects the carp may have escaped from a flooded farm dam in the catchment or been used as live bait. He thinks it's extremely unlikely the fish could have come from a pipeline connecting the Murrumbidgee River to Googong, and says carp pose no threat to Canberra's drinking water supply.
No, it will have no effect because Googong's water is fully treated before it gets to Canberra taps.
I mean, this fish can swallow a small child.
But there are fears that native fish stocks in Googong could suffer, particularly if carp numbers boom over the next decade.
It's devastating news, it really is. Like, it's really sad. So I never thought that the carp would get in there. All is not lost, but we definitely need a solution.
Authorities have stocked more predatory native fish here, like Murray cod and golden perch, in an attempt to keep carp numbers low. But one female carp can lay a million eggs, and authorities say once they're in, they're extremely difficult to control.